Hi, Chicken Genius here, and welcome back to another video. There are four ways to power your car: fossil fuel, direct charging of electricity, fuel cell, and compressed natural gas. I'll be talking about why electricity is the only way that makes sense, and how these three other methods is going to be irrelevant in the long term. There are many processes to get the energy to your car, and along this way, there are many inefficiencies. So I'm going to cover with you why only charging your car is the best way forward. When we look at fossil fuels like petrol and diesel, how this petrol and diesel gets to you is by three main processes. The first way is to dig the crude oil out. Second way is to refine it. And the third way, transports to your local fuel station where you pump gas. At the digging process itself, not every single drop of oil that comes out are being processed. There is this very good video done by Hassan Minhaj on Patriot Act, available on Netflix. I'll give a link in the description below. And he covers the amount of damage digging oil process has done to this world. The amount of oil spills that occur every year will just destroy so much life and nature in this world. There's also this factor that a lot of people don't consider, is the evaporation loss at storage tanks, both at the tankers and the petrol station itself. These storage tanks has evaporation loss. I was reading some report somewhere that in US, right, there are some fuel stations has evaporation loss of up to 20% of fuel. You also have to consider the amount of energy used to dig oil and refine oil. That is massive amount of energy being used. Next I want to talk about is CNG, compressed natural gas. Compressed natural gas is basically methane. Methane is one of the worst cause of pollution, and it makes up about 10% of our greenhouse gases. Methane is found near oil wells and is one of the byproducts of fossil fuel industry. These gas are then compressed and transported into storage tanks. Thirdly, we have fuel cell. Fuel cell technology is quite simple. You just take hydrogen and oxygen, and it creates power to power the electric motor inside your fuel cell car. So to create hydrogen, you need to build things that can create hydrogen, and it's very expensive to construct and maintain these facilities. The storage of hydrogen is also not easy, and this compressed hydrogen is super highly dangerous and combustible. Anyway, you come to think of it this way, you go through so much process just to create the hydrogen, and this hydrogen is to create electricity to power the electric motor. So you still realize it's still a big chain. The final way is just directly charging your car with electricity. It's just like the way we power our mobile phones. It's crazy if you're going to power your mobile phones by petrol. Nobody's ever going to do that. No matter where your power comes from, it could come from renewable energies, or it come from natural gas, which is the most common right now, or it could be coming from coal power plants. This power is just transferred through an electrical line towards your car. That's it. So there is no inefficiency in between. So however you think of it, this process makes the most sense. Even though your source of power could be very dirty, that is why what I think Tesla is doing, which is transiting the world to sustainable energy, is going to work in the long term. Hey friends, can you help me like this video so you can help me spread this message out to more people to understand about what Tesla is doing? And it'd be good if you give me a subscribe and on that notification bell. Thank you so much. Good. Bye.